playing in the number four spot and playing left field. Number 25, Barry Bonds.
If you can get 50-something thousand people to ballpark to boo you, you gotta be damn good.
And Bonds, however, is moving up on that home run list, and a lot of people feel that it's not right, and so he's in the center of controversy. I mean, how is he going to stay focused on the job at hand?
This is not the first time Barry Bonds has been embroiled in controversy. He has been able to handle everything until this point. And in some ways, I think the batter's box becomes a sanctuary.
They've always booed him here, but I did sense a little bit more hostility.
I mean, they boo Barry in every ballpark around the country. First ball swinging. Roberts on the move. And he's not going to be able to get to that one. It bounces up and over the wall. An automatic double for Barry Bonds on the first pitch he sees to start the 2006 season.
They needed a villain, you know, so I became the villain all the time. If you're not guilty of anything, why are you being charged? I mean, that's not our society. That's not the American way. I don't wish this upon any person ever. This whole thing had to do with Barry Bonds and a record. Can't stop, won't stop, that makes MVP.
Good morning, Arizona. Today is the day, folks. Finally, Barry Bonds is supposed to show up in Giants camp for what he's saying might be his last season in baseball. Building.
You're trolling for quotes, but really, you know, a lot of times it's just difficult because you just have some really simple questions you want to ask him. How are you feeling? How's the knee holding up? When do you think you're going to play? And he gets very defensive sometimes on questions like that.
My relationship with them has always been rocky. At one point in my career, it became kind of fun. It was a big motivating thing for me. Because without their negativity, I probably wouldn't have been as good as I am.
You don't know if conciliatory Barry is going to show up. You just don't know. You don't know what kind of mood he's going to be in.
I've been in pain since 1985. Do you think they buy a ticket to not see me go on that baseball field?
The record is what it is. I mean, the record's Hank's record. As far as I'm concerned, it's still Hank's record.
I cannot imagine being a player of that magnitude. He's Michael Jordan, you know what I mean? Where, you know, you can go to different countries and people know Barry Bonds.
I only throw a stone if the stone is thrown at me.
You know, you treat the media like hell for 20 years, which is his prerogative. There's a lot of guys with access to grind.
No, I could be an ass if I want to be. That's for damn sure. But it's only if you're an ass with me. I treat you the way you treat me.
I remember him telling me one time that when he gets out of the game, he has a lot to people to apologize to. And I just said, B, when that happens, it can be too late.
Barry was rude to various people over the years, and these people may have understandably had it in for Barry and looked for ways of getting back at him, which would be sad, but at the same time, something maybe that he brought on himself.
As much strength it gives him on one side, it probably might create some loneliness on the other side. You know what I mean?
I don't do interviews with you, really. We don't have anything to talk about.
To me, it's a stare of distrust. He's not really sure where people are coming from, where they're going after him, what they want from him.
And then sometimes, like in 2005, he just came in with a chip on his shoulder, and he was going to attack us in the media after all the steroid stories came out.
I don't believe steroids can help you eye-hand coordination, technically, hit a baseball.
You know, the only reason he didn't win four straight MVPs is just people didn't like it.
But you can't, you guys are like rerun stories. This is just, I mean, it's old stuff. I mean, it's like watching Sanford and Son. You know, you just rerun after rerun after rerun.
I don't know, when they ask, like, questions like, you know, how do you think the Giants are going to do? And I may say, it's f***ing February. How the f*** do I know? Like, do I look like the f***ing fairy godmother here? I can predict the future?
To me, it's just the, my getting ready for preparing for my job problem. Being able to have that space to prepare for my job. That's where myself and the media clashed.
That's my whole power is right here, baby. And yet he can be the most charming person just about on the planet. The thing is, he's so intelligent that it's a shame to waste the opportunity to be able to hear what he has to say.
The 10 most hated athletes. Oh, that's what you give me. Phil Mickelson, how did he ain't hated? Okay, Bonzi Wells, no, he's not a criminal. Kobe Bryant, that was just for a moment. Curt Schilling, yeah, he could be in there with us. And then you got me second. Who said this? And T.O., how did T.O. get in front of me? That's bullshit right there, man. That's
see, that's why you're in AAA. You're supposed to catch the balls. Yeah, but I'm guaranteed.
Barry is probably one of the strongest minds to block all that stuff out that I've ever been around, and you know, he goes about his business, and it can't be easy.
I happen to be in a cage, unfortunately. It's because baseball feels a cage. I'm inside this cage, but it's the only time that I get to express myself the way that I want to express myself. You know, I notice that we're all kind of like going through the motions, so I try and challenge everybody into a game. So I told Vizcaino, for every home run you hit, I have to hit three.
I think the greatest part of it was him coming out and all of us coming out and having fun and being ourselves. And this is our release.
Oh, shit. Shut up! Shut up! Yeah!
Yeah, you got robbed.
Oh, this is awesome.
Barry Bonds is back by the Bay today to attend a custody hearing for his son, while a book excerpt in Sports Illustrated has everyone in baseball talking about the allegations.
How do you feel about the Sports Illustrated thing? I don't care, man. I got more problems than that.
Entitled Game of Shadows and written by two San Francisco Chronicle reporters.
Right now, you know, I think, like, of all the shit that I've been through, dude, I could just, like, literally just kill somebody. No, I mean, straight, just want to just, I don't even, you know, when I make statements like I could kill somebody, I just sit there and say, you know, I wish killing was legal, but I'd probably be the first one shot. See, look, my people, see? That's my homie right there. These are my people.
What's up, partner?
You all right, man?
I know.
You all right?
You know how they do it?
That right there made my whole day.
The paparazzis, man. Did you ever think that anyone outside Queen Elizabeth or something would ever have a paparazzi? That's for like Paris Hilton and stuff like that, man. That ain't for me. Ain't that good looking.
This is kind of fun, you know. This is kind of like some Bonnie and Clyde, don't you think? You know, like you're running from the fofo and stuff?
He's running, man. He's running.
They're pissed off too because they're like, how's he get into the side door?
Yeah.
I got a case with my kid, man. I ain't got time to deal with this stuff too.
Apologize or acknowledge Jason's insurance. If you guys want to cover that door, we'll cover this door.
He's phony and a liar and a cheat. Yeah. What a way to go out.
One person's at the elevator. Gannon hit that shot coming down, so we have stuff.
He's gonna since he came in over there.
Ron Vitale says he's launching a review of your case. Do you have any comment?
Any comment about the Brooklyn Bonds?
How are you guys doing?
What are you going to do?
Just a few words, Barry. Deny the allegations in the book.
How do things go today?
Can we get any comments on the book? Anything you'd like to say to your fans? I love them.
Excuse me, I'd like to get into the elevator with my client. Thank you.
How to go with you in court today, Barry?
Please put your hands back so the doors will shut. Thank you.
Hey, don't become a star, man. This is what you go through, dog. I'm telling you, man. Have you ever seen anything like it in your life? It's hilarious, isn't it? It's like, holy crud.
I'm just soaking it in.
Watch. Yeah, man. Just stay under the radar, man. You never have to worry about it. Thing has been going on, what, 3 years running now? Go out there and do my job. I ain't got to worry about it. It's just part of it, man. I just say it's like a Hank Aaron story, but just a different subject. That's all it is. The hate mail has been here for so long. You kind of get numb inside to it. You don't feel it anymore. You know, if you're always put down all the time and just constantly put down, you either believe it or you have to just ignore it. I got more "I'm gonna kill you, nigga" on my email than you can imagine. I don't know how people are tracking down my phone sometimes and call me names on my phone at times, etc. So I get that every single day.
What? That's weighing on you. This whole steroid controversy.
The commissioner said he was planning to look into this latest stuff in this book.
Do you want to talk baseball or do you not want to talk at all?
You don't want to say whether you've heard from him.
Do you want to talk baseball or do you not want to talk at all?
The thing about the steroid scandal is the fact is like this. We are bound by a court which keeps everything lip locked. You know, I'm bound by a union in baseball, bound by Major League Baseball rules of regulations, and by my lawyer. People think I'm afraid, but that's not the case at all. Anyone who knows me, I'm not jealous of anybody. Anyone. Mark McGwire, when he hit that home run, I'm the one who sent a telegram out there to congratulate him. I'm proud of what Mark McGwire did. I'm proud of what Sammy did. I mean, they lifted the game, period. Regardless of what anybody says. I mean, whatever accusations you want, I don't care. They made the game different for a lot of people.
10 years ago, if someone had said to me, you know what? You might be able to make $160 million for your families and descendants, and it's not against the rules in the workplace, and there's no test for it. Can you honestly say you wouldn't have done it?
I probably would have used steroids. Who am I to say, looking back, that I would have refused an opportunity to lift my game to their level? If it allows you to recover from injury faster, bottom line, if it allows you to create more bat speed, which is what we all think it does, why wouldn't I have used it?
Let me say hello to the USA team, man. How you doing, baby? Good. How you doing?
How you feeling, man?
I'm good, man. I can't complain. What's up, baby? How you doing, man?
You all right?
USA.
That's my daughter, Asia.
Say hey.
Just what Barry Bonds needs. Another book excerpted in ESPN Magazine now reports that Bonds, in a meeting at Ken Griffey Jr.'s home in 1998, declared his intent to start using, quote, some hardcore stuff.
I heard stuff with Ken Griffey Jr., and that pissed me off. I mean, pissed me off. As well as everything else has pissed me off. But don't bring my family in this, and Kenny's family. You know, Kenny is family.
Off the table? Right? I'm sorry, he didn't care. He's like,
in 1998, I wasn't at Ken Griffey Jr.'s house. I was not in Florida in 1998.
We have a very special guest who just stepped into the booth, Barry Bonds. Mike Schmidt and Barry Bonds. And here's Derek Jeter swinging and looping one in the shallow right. That's a base hit. But one thing I really want to know is, what do you want your legacy to be?
Kyle Ripken stated it perfect. Just being remembered, period, is a legacy. If you're remembered, period, then you've done something. So, you know, whatever the fans want to remember you by, whatever baseball wants to remember you by, then that's okay with me.
It's hard to envision a scenario of 10, 15, 20 years from now, his name coming up without this whole steroid thing still hanging over him.
Maybe one day when it's all over, maybe minds will change, and if it doesn't, there's nothing I can do about it anyway. I mean, what damage is done to me, I've never changed. There's not one friend that you ever talk to in my life that says Barry Bonds is any different from when he was in high school. Barry Bonds didn't give a shit then. Barry Bonds don't give a shit now.
Barry Bonds, he plays for Arizona State, and his father was a super big league ball player.
Your dad's a professional baseball player, so the scouts look at you to do a lot more than, you know, any of the other kids that their parents aren't professional baseball players. I learn, I watch, I listen to them, I tell them how I do. You know, we talk a lot, but when it comes down to it, I really have to do it all by myself.
The senior Bonds, Bobby, was a premier player in the major leagues for many years. This, of course, has been helpful for the freshman who was the Giants' second-round pick out of high school.
They didn't give me the money that I wanted. You know, I wanted 75, they said 70. You know, people say, what's 5,000? 5,000's better than no 5,000, you know?
Wearing number 24 like his godfather, Willie Mays, the young Bonds has a bright future in this game.
Baseball to me, I didn't like baseball because everybody was always drunk. I mean, I saw my dad drink all the time. And that wasn't the life I wanted to live. I think what happened was is that you took him from basically the ghetto and put money in his pocket and fame, and everyone else was doing it, he followed track. My dad changed when I went to college. And ever since then, my father and I were like really tight. And my dad, remind you, I'm a recovery alcoholic all the time, but my dad didn't take a drink ever since I was in college. My dad came to me in a way of apologizing, as I could say. Like, my dad was saying, I'm sorry for all that happened in his own way by coaching me. And he became my hitting coach. And my dad could show me something that would work faster than I've ever seen in my entire life. But the way he did it, he made me call, you're an idiot, you're this, how can you be so damn stupid, the f*** are you thinking about? But my dad was like, I could see in the cage going, I can't get it. The f*** you mean you can't get to it? F***ing ball's right in front of you, can you see? You know, and I'm sitting there thinking, geez, this dude is wacko, man, you know? And I would do it to despise him. I would do it better than he would say it, just to shut him up. So when he said I could hit a ball over the fence in left field, I hit 20 of them. And I'd hand him the bat and walk away. If my dad told me I couldn't fly, I guarantee you I'd fly. That's how bad I wanted to prove him wrong. That's how I became the player I am today.
It's really great for me to come back home and, you know, I get to be back with my family.
Then I signed with the Giants and I found out that, you know, my dad was going to be the hitting coach and Dusty Baker was going to be the manager. And I just thought we were going to get lynched because you got a black manager. My father was going to sneak through the door and then me as the highest paid player. I knew what I was up against.
We have the press conference tonight.
There's nothing that I've ever achieved that really made me feel better than to know that
that it was something that he had decided to do. So I have the honor of presenting my old number, number 25, to my son and a new San Francisco Giants, Barry Bonds.
Was starting to feel sick all the time, and we couldn't understand it. From that point on, my dad was diagnosed with lung cancer, and they said he was gonna die. And that's what the doctor said. My dad always said he's gonna fight it, so we all stuck with him.
You know, the day of his birthday, maybe a week or two before his dad passed away, against Arizona in a pennant race scenario, Barry throws out a guy at the plate. Now, Barry leads off in the last half of the inning. And Arizona brings in this guy who'd been a longtime nemesis of Barry, the sidewinder, Mike Myers.
The submariner delivers, and Bond swings, a drive deep into left center, way back there. The ball game is over. Barry Bonds throws out the go-ahead run at the plate, and moments later, he launches one. Goodbye. Happy birthday, Barry Bonds.
On his birthday, instead of blowing out candles, he went in, quickly changed, and ran to the hospital to spend the rest of the day and evening with his father, Bobby.
I sleep with my dad. We're laying on the floor. We're bathing my father because my dad couldn't even take a bath. He couldn't take a shower without someone helping him because he couldn't breathe. 1 o'clock in the morning, my mom calls me up and says something's wrong. I go to my mom and dad's house and watch my dad die in front of my face at 8 o'clock in the morning, me and my brother.
He's been the person that has gotten me to where I am today, and I just pray with all his teaching and instructions I'll be able to continue it on.
I think my dad died too early. 57's too young. And I never played against another team. I always played against my father and Willie. Their approval of, am I as good as they are? Or did I get their acceptance as a baseball player? I blame my dad for a lot of stuff, but you're the product of your environment. I don't know. I tell my dad I'm doing okay. You know, I'm doing good. I tell him the game has changed a lot. But they're more out to trying to discredit anything that you do than appreciate anything that you do. But I just want him to know I still love you, and I'm still here. See you around, Pop.
The only reason you play is for a World Series ring. It's the only reason. Other than that, no one, I mean, you pay for a paycheck too. I ain't gonna lie, I like my paycheck. Don't get me wrong. I ain't getting taken less. But championship is what you play for. That's the only thing I play for. I think that's also what keeps me going. It's something that, you know, I don't have.
I mean, everybody plays for the ring. It's been a long time since I got in the ring, 81. And you yearn and you quest. The quest for the ring is similar to like the Holy Grail almost sometimes.
I played in a lot of championship games. Never won but one of them. I've been to 3 CCS championships in high school and lost those. I've been in, I believe, 2 or 3 summer league championships. I lost those. I can't even count how many playoffs I've been in.
For a while there, it seemed like it was a psychological thing, you know, where Barry wouldn't perform nearly as well as he's capable of performing.
Strike, you're out. And that
that's a fourth strikeout for Rio, and Bonds doesn't quarrel, and he's having a tough series.
And we're just like choking right now.
He managed a feeble 167 performance against Cincinnati last year. The Reds used four lefty starters in six games. For Bonds, NLCS seems to stand for never less comfortable swinging. Bobby Cox even had the nerve to put Bobby Bonilla on base twice in a row just to get to the slumping Bonds.
Barry, are you feeling any pressure yourself? Are you concerned that this slump and so forth is going to continue through the series?
What slump?
Same thing that happened last year.
Who's slump?
Your slump, your batting slump.
I don't have a slump.
Got him! The Wolves continue for Barry Bonds.
Like I said, I've lost so many championships to get to the World Series. I didn't have an opinion in the World Series. I didn't know what to expect. Only thing I ever know what to expect in the playoffs or World Series is if I don't do good, what I'm going to deal with.
He didn't want to get there. He didn't want to get there all his life. I don't think Bobby got there either, you know? So you want to get there for yourself, and you want to get there for your mom and dad, too.
Truthfully, the greatest thing about the World Series is not that only I was in it. Was the fact of is that I was with the Giants, you know what I mean? I had a lot to do with Pittsburgh, but this is where I was raised, you know what I mean?
Ripped into right field. It's a one-run game as Bonds gets his second of the series. Deep right field, salmon back. At the wall. It's off the wall. Two runs are going to score. Lofton digs for third. Six-run Giants lead.
Darren Baker, who's only 3 years old, was standing almost in the direct line between David Bell and home plate.
Well, fortunately, JT Snow didn't have to run hard home. So.
And the play wasn't over, and JT got him out of the way. But we were used to the kids always being there, so it didn't really matter to us.
Barry was convinced that my son was probably the most advanced bad boy out there. He says the best bad boy we had.
Never made a mistake, ever. Always got the bat run on schedule, always did everything perfect. He wanted to get Kenny Lofton's bat that one time.
Go on, Barry, get him, boy. You a baker, go get him, baby.
Barry is probably as nice to my son as I've seen him be to anybody. And he's extremely nice to kids. Inside, I think he's a big old kid, because you got to be a big kid to get along with kids. That's what I think on the inside, you know. Externally, he's this tough, hard guy, but inside, he's, you know, like, he has a big heart. It's hard to get in that heart sometimes, that's all.
In 2002, after the first game, I was doing the highlights, so Francisco Rodriguez comes in, and nobody had touched that cutter. So Barry, after he hits the tremendous home run off Purcell, gets one of those cutters, grounds out the first base.
And the Giants go in order.
So I say during the highlights that the first time seeing it, that's a very difficult pitch. Barry didn't square the ball. The next day he comes out, you're completely wrong. You're wrong. He said, I just took a bad swing. If he ever throws that pitch to me, I'll hit it further than I did off Purcell. Game six, in comes Frankie Rodriguez. He throws the same pitch and he hits it further than Purcell. Our set was up in left field in Anaheim, and Barry's coming out the left field going
4-0 Giants.
I don't celebrate till the game's over. I don't care what the score is. I'm not the rah-rah dude. I'll be like, good job, dog, and keep on focusing in, because I've seen so many times people come from behind and kick my butt.
Dusty Baker taking no chances here. They are fully equipped, rested, and a strong bullpen.
You know, Russ got in trouble. And Barry was probably shaking his head out in left field. You know, I know Barry.
Dusty never took out his big guy. And sometimes Russ Ortiz only got in trouble in the later innings.
Russ Ortiz. He has done himself and his organization, the Giants, very proud tonight.
Dusty always made the really cool decisions when it was the right time. And Fifi ain't never give up no three-run home run, period.
Spezio hits one into deep right field. Back is Sanders. 5-3 in the seventh.
We were all sitting in the dugout. We really thought we had it won. I went up in the clubhouse and they had the champagne out and all the stuff was up, and we really thought we had the game won.
Smack in the right. It's a one-run game.
Well, what happened to all this? All of a sudden now you all like this.
Into left center field. Bonds on the run, won't get it. And the Anaheim Angels have come all the way back and lead it 6-5.
When we were in the shower, and matter of me and JT Snow were both looked at each other and went, what happened? Game 7 came so fast the next day. We were still worn out from Game 6.
The Angels World Champions.
I hated the fact that we lost because it was just a painful thing. But it was now, what are you going to say? Who are you going to point the finger at now? I'm already complete as a player without a ring. But it'd be a lot more satisfying to have one, that's all. I got a championship ring, and that's, you know, that's good, but that's not like the... I want that one that's, like, big, like the Dallas Cowboys get, you know, that's, like, this big. It'd be nice to have something with some diamonds on it other than my wife's wedding.
Some much-needed rain finally falling on the Valley this morning, but never an off day in the Barry Bonds controversy as more accusations trickle in.
He should do endorsements for human growth hormone. I gotta believe he's still powered by HGH. Wow.
Skip. 911, brother. This ain't a good morning right now. The pipe underneath the fish tank busted. You guys need to get to my house ASAP. I'm just sorry, Mom. Your pipe busted.
This thing is thrashed.
Your lights just went out because I think it just fused the light. No, right in there.
Okay, I told you you can have my fish.
You're lucky you're six. Because I would just kill you right now.
Considering where you were when you came back last year, how are you in comparison to that? Are you
way better?
Way better?
Way ahead of schedule. They found a brace that helps separate my knee a little bit. It takes away the pounding. I never hit bone to bone. I wish I had that last year because I probably would have been back a lot sooner.
Barry, how did the surgery go?
Can you get my son in this too, just not on me? So you guys can.
He's in there.
Sure. Pain that you're causing my whole family.
Pain?
My knee surgery, I don't know, it's fine.
I was rock bottom that time with my son in that interview over my knee. And I knew something was wrong because I know my body better than anyone. And I know when there's something wrong, and I know when there's something not right. And I was afraid for myself.
You wanted me to jump off the bridge, I finally have jumped. You wanted to bring me down, you finally have brought me and my family down. You finally have done it.
I was more afraid for myself that I'm not gonna be able to come out of this. What am I gonna do? You know, what am I gonna do now? I'm not done yet. There's, you know, all those things came in my head at that time. I'm not finished. Got this leg to start and this knee to start talking to each other.
Keep my jacket on, man. It's kind of cold here today in the city. I never miss an opening day as a starter in my life. I'm going, this is odd, man. This is crazy.
I don't really even know what happened. I just was doing exercises in a training room, and next minute my knee was blown up.
I'm just trying to get to a couple more home runs, and I can shut it down.
I see my mobile? Is the inflammation predicated on some arthritis and inflammation, or is there an infection?
If the skin is punctured or broken for any reason, that bacteria can enter the wound and cause an infection.
Cut it off. I'll play it one leg. I'm thinking like all the worst scenarios a person can think of about his knee, but I knew something was seriously wrong.
Man.
You're walking
kind of fast. Oh, dear. If I'm going to lay down, pass out.
Barry could be out for a long, long time. He may never come back
to it. I'm feeling sorry for myself. Things that I tell other people not to do. You can't feel sorry for yourself. Pick yourself up. You know, it's easy to tell somebody else something, but it's hard, you know, to look yourself in the mirror sometimes and have to tell your damn self. The team was coming back, and they were getting back into the race. And everyone around me was, Barry, you can help. Barry, you can get them through this. I said, I can't even walk. In rehab all the time down in Los Angeles, and I was talking to Clive. And I was talking to Dr. Yoakum, and I talked to Dr. Tink, and I asked him, can I do it? Do you think I can do it? Hey, Barry, we think you can do anything you want.
This is going to be hard. And if it gets hard, what does that mean? That's not good.
My mom told me, you better get back to work. Called me up about 2 weeks prior to me going back. And said, the team needs you, but most of all, you need those fans. You need those people out there, boy. And without those people, you're gonna feel like this for the rest of your life if you don't go back.
It's a double.
No, it ain't still no home run. That's a home run. I don't give a damn what they say. That ball hit that boy's arm over the fence. They can say whatever they want. But you know what? I had a home run off of Candiotti and Candlestick. He know it. And they called it not a home run. But in the flip side of that, I've hit some balls that they reached over the fence that they gave me home runs too. So, it, you know, it all evens itself out. So.
Feel if we had an extra 2 weeks, we'd have definitely been in the playoffs.
So with their playoff hopes finished, the Giants will shut Bonds down for the rest of the season. He'll pick up the chase next season, six homers shy of the Babe.
My heights are past Babe Ruth. My heights are past Hank Aaron. But that's not what I'm playing the game for. I'm playing the game to be the best that I can be for my team. Now, if that gets in the way of Babe Ruth and that gets in the way of Hank Aaron, then so be it. But I'm not, that's not my focus point.
Now, every time he hits one, there's the historic reference. How much closer is he to the Babe? How many does he need to go to catch Henry Aaron? And then also, should this count? Is this not right? Did he do it artificially? And so on and so forth. And so, you know, in a way, it's almost like, this, you know, Greek tragedy.
Has vowed to conduct a thorough review of the Bonds case.
It's so hard at times. It's just a tough moment for me right now. I have so much on my shoulders, so much weight on my back. Constantly climbing that hill is getting a lot harder and harder by the day, but I'm gonna climb it no matter what.
Look at that movement, too much movement. I'll fix that tomorrow.
The chase is what it is. That's for the other people in the public to make their assumptions of that chase.
When Barry passes Ruth, it will be a major topic. And I'm sure people in baseball would love for Barry to announce he's going to retire and not deal with this. But it's just, you know, there are certain things you have to deal with.
Here he goes!
I mean, what would everyone want? Me to have the worst spring of my whole career? Well, hitting is an everyday thing. Willie and I go over those kind of things that my dad used to talk to me about.
I got to get more consistent right there. And right now, that's the only thing that's... I think I'm just leaning my front elbow instead of dropping his head through it.
Yeah, this one I got to be here, but this one I got to be level. And then boom.
Three home runs on the spring for Mr. Bonds.
Drive to right. What do you know? Out of here.
In a national poll, only 49% of fans say they think Bonds should be elected to the Hall of Fame. And 46% say they'd just as soon see the Giant slugger retire.
There has been significant public speculation concerning allegations that a number of major league players use steroids and other illegal performance-enhancing drugs.
I'm drained. I'm mentally, emotionally drained. I mean, I get so tired of it, it's just ridiculous because I take on a lot, and this is where the emotion comes out because it's tough. And I'm not gonna allow anyone to bring me down.
I have no doubts about how good of a baseball player he is. I respect him for that. I don't respect him for the way that, like you said, he treats people and for the way that he's attacked the integrity of the game.
I think they're picking on him. I think because he is such a celebrity, they're picking
on him. He's a
standout.
I think Bud Selig should force him to retire or force him out of the game. At the most, at the very least, his record should have some kind of an asterisk with it.
If it makes them happy to go out of their way to try to destroy me or whatever they want to try to do, go right ahead, man. It doesn't bother me. You can't do anything else you've already done. You can't hurt me any more than you've already hurt me. You can't hurt my family any more than you've already hurt my family. You don't see me taking on anything with anybody else. And you don't see me bringing anyone else into this. I take it myself. And I'm gonna take it. Because there's so many other people that depend on me. And I think I stand up for them too. It's not just me. They can take me down. Who gives a fuck? I don't really care. I never care. Baseball, and they want to take me down, go right ahead. Take it. Take all the shit you want. Anyone who's ever known me, I don't give a fuck. I don't care. But there's so many other people that depend on me to stay strong. I wish I could just walk away. Like, leave this game. But then I let my father down, my mom down, myself, everybody, my teammates. I don't need their f***ing money. I don't really care. I've never really cared about that anyway. I just want to just play ball, and that's just it. You got this half of people that hate you.
Plenty of booze.
And then you have this other half that roots for you. Why should I let them down? Why should I let them down for all these other people? Why should I let myself down? You know, why should I let my kids down? I just can't do that.
This ain't a movie, no. No fairy tale conclusion, y'all. It gets more confusing every day. Sometimes it's heaven sent, then we head back to hell again. We kiss, then we make up on the way. I hang up, you call, we rise and we fall, and we feel like just walking away. As our love advances, we take second chances. Though it's not a fantasy, I still want you.
So, two down, Phillies right to Khalil Green, and the Padres have won the opener, beating the Giants and Barry Bonds 6-1.
Today, unfortunately, we didn't win it. Now, this is just the beginning of a long-distance run. I come out of here in a big, huge mic.
You've been booed before. You'll be booed again. Is this any different today?
I picked up a syringe that a fan had thrown out on the field. What do you think of that?
I just put it off the field so no one could hurt.
You wouldn't want that to happen again, would you? Someone throwing a syringe on the field.
What's your approach?
What do you mean by my approach? See it, hit it. That's the only approach I got.
What about signs?
I can't read anyway, so it doesn't matter.
I'm a Giants fan, but I want to see real players, real athletes. I'd like to see Barry go.
I almost crashed my car. I was so horrified. I went to call the mayor's office, the police.
Oh, wow. I didn't see that.
Can you guys just let me just chill out now? Or do you
sure.
just want to keep yakking?
Yeah.
Come on.
Yeah.
There's other people on this team. Not more other people on this team.
Music featured in this episode of Bonds on Bonds provided by 456 Productions, AD, Chris Classic, and John Legend.